गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्य कृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विदाति पूर्वं वेदाश्च प्रहिणोति तस्मै तगुंहदेवात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुरुवै शरणं प्रपद्ये। शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्री चिद्घन गणेश नमो मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सुप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम अधिष्ठानं बुद्धि बोध्यं बुद्धेतुकेतु पारं सर्ववेदान्त वेद्यं प्रत्येक परं महा तदेव शितामतिः। So in the last part we saw how virtue got vairagya. So prakara is mentioned here. Sri putra dhanadi nam dukkha nidanattvam ekanta sthitehe sukha hetuttvam cha virtuhu yatha nishtikaya tatha idani varnyate. So now the details of how virtue nischayena chikaya, how he landed on definite vairagya or how he attained vairagya definitely, that prakara is mentioned here, the details are given. And what is the final conclusion there that he has? Stri, putra and dhana, all of these and adipadena, everything else, laukika, leads to dukkha. So dukkha karana, dukkha nidanam is dukkha karanattvam. Esham. Whereas ekanta sthitehe sukha hetuttvam, there is sukha in ekanta vasa. Therefore ekanta sevinaha sarva bhavadi brahma paryanta ananda labha. So Taittiriya Upanishad has a section of gradations of ananda, describing the gradations of ananda across upadhi. So this is where we were in the Brahmananda valli. So there is a Ananda Mimamsa. Analysis of Ananda is being done across Upadhis, and whoever has Vairagya for the Ananda in the next Upadhi, which is supposed to give 100-fold Ananda, that person, that Vairagi, gets the next level of Ananda, which is 100-fold. That's the idea. So here it is simplified in prose form and said, Tatahi Udadi Mekhalayaha Vasudayaha Adipasya. And we have seen that it is for an emperor, the Manusha Ananda unit is compared of an ideal person, and that ideal person is happens to be an emperor of the who rules over the entire earth. So that kind of a Vasudhayaha Adipasya Adipati. And what kind of Vasudhaya? Entire earth surrounded by all the oceans. Apratihate parakramasya. And who is not won over by anyone. Nathakila samantasya. Has no enemies around. Everyone is, each of the other kings also bows down to him, and therefore this king is an emperor. So even if he has resources, maybe he cannot enjoy it because he is old and then does not have functional indriyas. No, that is not so. Navayovanasya, one who is in his youth. Sarva vidya visharadasya. So okay, he is young, but then he has enough wealth, but still he has no knowledge of shastras, thereby sukha will not be Shastriya Sukha, meaning Dharmika. If that is the idea, then Sarva Vidya Visharadasya. He is a Shrotriya. So Sarva Vidya Visharadasya Anukula Sakala Parivarasya. And has Sakala Parivar Anukula is there. Sarva Bhavasya, that kind of an emperor, फॉर दैट काइंड ऑफ एम्परर व्हाट एवर आनंद इज देयर तस्य आनंदः मानुष आनंद इत्युच्यते दैट इज द फर्स्ट बेसिक यूनिट ऑफ आनंद सेट टू बी ह्यूमन यूनिट ऑफ आनंद इज नॉट एक्चुअली सुपर ह्यूमन रियली इफ इट इज नॉट ह्यूमन नो वन कैन गेट दिस काइंड ऑफ आनंद इट इज अ हाइपोथेसिस एंड इफ यू टेक दैट एज वन यूनिट ऑफ आनंद देन सोपि आनंद सातिशैव दैट इज ऑल्सो लिमिटेड वाई बिकॉज देर इज नेक्स्ट लेवल ऑफ आनंद ततः शतगुणित आनंद मनुष्य गंधर्वस्य सो देर इज अ मनुष्य गंधर्व हू हैज 100 टाइम्स आनंद एज दिस एंड दिस इज हाउ द सीक्वेंस कंटिन्यूज वील जस्ट लुक एट नेम्स एंड 100 फूड सो आई विल जस्ट रीड थ्रू तथा शतगुण आनंद देव गंधर्वस्य सो देर इज अ डिफरेंशिएशन टू बी मेड बिटवीन मनुष्य गंधर्व एंड देव गंधर्व टिप्पणकार से अस्मिन्नेव कल्पे मनुष्य भूत्वा पुण्यविशेषात् गंधर्वत्वं यः प्राप्तः स मनुष्य गंधर्व सो मनुष्य गंधर्व इज वन हू हैज अटेन्ड सो मच ऑफ पुण्य टू बिकम अ गंधर्व इन दिस जन्म इटसेल्फ इन द ह्यूमन बर्थ इटसेल्फ पूर्व कल्पानुष्ठित धर्माधिक्यात् अस्मिन् कल्पादौ एव गंधर्वत्वं यः प्राप्तः स देव गंधर्व वेर एज देव गंधर्वाज आर दोस हू हैव accrued punya for becoming gandharva in the earlier janma and in this kalpa itself they become gandharvas compared to that gandharva deva gandharva ananda is what tatopi shataguna ananda pitrunam so pitrus have 100 times ananda pitrulokeshu chirakalam ye vasanti agnishvattadayah so there is agnishvatta is one of the You know, from the Manu family, who is also the ancestors for human beings. Therefore, those have a vasa, chirakala vasa in this pitruloka. They are called as pitaraha. That is pitruloka there. So pitrunam these are pitrus and they have anandas, ananda which is more than 100-fold than devagandharva. Tatashataguna anandaha. आजान देवस्य ततशतगुणानंद कर्मदेवस्य ततशतगुणानंद मुख्य देवस्य ततशतगुणानंद इंद्रस्य सो इंद्र बीइंग द लॉर्ड ऑफ ऑल देवास देवानामपि देवः देयरफॉर राज ही इज अ देवराज देवराज इंद्र देयरफॉर ही विल हैव मोर आनंद 100 टाइम्स मोर देन द मुख्य देवास सो वी विल सी व्हाट दीज आर इन द टिप्पणा ऑल एट वंस ततः शतगुणानंद बृहस्पतेः बृहस्पति बीइंग द Guru even of Indra, he has 100 times more ananda than Indra. Tataha shataguna ananda prajapatehe. So the Brahma, Chaturmukha Brahma has 100 times ananda than Brahaspati. Some gradation is given. Tataha shataguna ananda Hiranyagarbhasya Brahmana. Hiranyagarbha at a more subtle level because Hiranyagarbha is connected to all antakkaranas. And this Hiranyagarbha Upasana leads to that kind of association with all antakkaranas, whereby one partakes of only sukha of all jivas, whether it is in prani sharira or in manushya sharira, deva sharira, rakshasa sharira, any sharira, in their antakkarana, whatever sukha bhoga is there, that is there for Hiranyagarbha, not the dukkha, mind you. Therefore, That is the highest limit of sukha one can attain through karma and upasana. Trivida paricheda rahitasya, we will come to this. So the Tippanakara says, Kalparambheva ye devatvam praptaha te ajana deva. So who are ajana deva? Those who have got devatvam at the beginning of the kalpa itself. Asmin kalpe ashwamedhadi krattvanushthanena praptananta ishwaryaha आजान देवैहि उपास्यमानः येते कर्मदेवा कर्मदेवाज आर दोज हु हैव अटेंड देवत्वम थ्रू द कर्म सच एज अश्वमेध इत्यादि व्हिच आर क्रतुस सो दोज क्रतु यज्ञस हैव लेड टू ऐश्वर्य ऐश्वर्य प्राप्ति इन दिस जन्म इटसेल्फ दे आर कर्मदेवास एंड दे आर उपास्य इवन फॉर आजान देव यम अग्नि वायु सूर्य चंद्रादि प्रधान देवः मुख्य देवः सो हु आर द देवास मुख्य देवास दे आर ऑल यम अग्नि दे हैव 100 फोल्ड मोर सुख देन कर्म देवास बिकॉज ऑफ द उपाधि इट अलाउज दैट काइंड ऑफ सुख केचित्तु So this is one way of understanding Mukhya Devas. Other way of understanding Mukhya Devas is Kechittu Yamadi Hiranya Garbhanta Devan Ashtau Vasun Dvadashadityan Ekadasha Durudra Anityevam Eka. So Rudra Ekadasha Rudran. Yeah, iti evam Eka Trimshad Devamcha Mukhya Devan Ahu. So other way to extend this is not only limited to these, but Yamadi Hiranya Garbhanta Garbhantan Devan. Garbhanta Devan means Hiranya Garbhanta. Starting with Yamaraja and ending with Hiranya Garbha, whichever Deva is there, all are included in Mukhya Deva. But then what will happen? Hiranya Garbha, if you include, then the next Brahma will not have no meaning. Therefore, Kechittu means the Tippanakara does not agree with this categorization, including Hiranyagarbha. Hiranyagarbha Antan, you can have to exclude him. But then others who will become included, they if they are mentioned separately, they have to be excluded. So Ashtau Vasun, eight Vasus, Dvadasha Adityas, Ekadasha Rudras, all of these. Iti evam Ekatrimshad Devan. So 31 are included there. Mukhya Devan Ahuhu. So that end, this Ananda gradation ends with the upadhi of Hiranyagarbha Brahma. Trivida Paricheda Rahitasya Brahmanaha tu Anandaha Niratishyaha Taratamya Rahitaha. Bereft of gradations is the Ananda, which is Swarupa Ananda, which is Brahmananda really. That is the Nirguna Brahma Ananda, which is the Lakshana of Swarupa Lakshana of Brahma, which is Trivida Paricheda Shunya. Trivida Paricheda Parichcheda Rahita. Therefore, the Ananda there cannot be quantified. It is immeasurable. Taratamya Rahita, there is no gradation possible the way it has been done till Chaturmukha Brahma Upadhi. Na Chatra Dukkhalesho Apyasti. So even Chaturmukha Brahma and Hiranyagarbha also may have some Dukkha, but there is no Dukkha Lesha also in Nirguna Brahma, because Swarupa itself is Ananda Swarupa, Ananta Ananda. Itham Praptavyasya Anandasya Kramaha Taitiriya Upanishadi Brahmavalyam Ashtamanuvake Varanitaha. So we have seen this, that it is mentioned in the Brahmananda Valli of Taitiriya Upanishad. What kind of Ananda is this? The Ananda with gradations. And the Ananda with gradations alone is experienceable and attainable. So, praptavyasya anandasya, that ananda which is available for experience, for objectification, that alone can have gradations. Sarvabhaumadi brahmanantam anandam ekantavasi akamata shrotriya anavratam anubhavati. Whereas the ananda of a akamahata shrotriya, one who is a shrotriya, shrotriya and akamahata. Akamahata is kamena na hataha. Na kamahataha. Kamena na hataha. One who has vairagya. He has anubhava, means swarupananda anubhava, anubhuti, which is said to be sarva bhaumadi brahmanantam. Beginning with the manusha ananda of the emperor as described, a youthful, dharmika, emperor who has the entire prapancha as his wealth. That kind of a beginning of ananda in gradations, ending with the brahmananda, brahma. So brahma ending with Chaturmukha Brahma and Hiranyagarbha Brahma. That ananda, this ekantavasi akamahata vairagi, who is a shrotriya, not without the shruti jnana, he enjoys it. Anavartaram, so anavaratam anubhavati, continuously, that is nityananda, because it is swarupananda. Ataha ekante sukamasti, and thereby it is established that ekante sukamasti. Dharapatya dhanasangastu sada dukkha pradaha eva iti bharchuhu nidharayamasa. So bharchu, what he did, he ascertained that any sukha that comes from being a couple, being married, and thereby the family brings in something. The relatives bring some ananda. There is wealth which brings in resources and thereby ananda. All that is with sangha. Whatever comes with sangha, with other upadhis, through one's own upadhi, all that is dukkha prada. Prakarshena dukkham dadati. In abundance and continuously there is dukkha. There may be momentary sukha, but then that fades away sooner than, you know, it is digested rather. So this is how virtue ascertained, and then he goes into each one of these. I'll speed through this. You'll get the meaning as I read. I don't want to go into details. I'll mention a little about this. So Stri Sangha, I had mentioned that Stri is taken as an example here. The flip side is equally true. So Vairagya, dissociation from Stri for a Purusha, and vice versa for the Stri, dissociation from Purusha, where the flaws are noted. So here the flaws of Stri will be mentioned. So take it with a pinch of salt, because it is equally true on the flip side. Similarly, may not be same, but similarly. So Stri Sangaja Dukkha Varananam. The Dukkha described, what kind of Dukkha? The Dukkha which is born due to association with the opposite gender. So I'll just keep it as opposite gender here. Sri Sangaha Dukkha Hetuhu. And since it is talking about Bharchu, who is a man, therefore the woman is described so that one gets Vairagya. And this is how he got Vairagya. So even if we don't get it, it is how he got it. That is the Varnana of Bharchu getting Vairagya. So it can be taken in that way. If people have, you know, there's some, you know, we will find objections there. Generally, it is not easily, any Vairagya is not easy to come by. So there is a lot of negatives that one has to focus on, which does not go well with everyone. So that's why I'm buffering it. But this is a fact, as it is seen in Shastras also. Stri Sango Dukkha Hetuhu Yasya Purva Papa Vashat Kuru Pini Durubhashini Cha Stri Prapta. So Stri here is in the sense of wife. So one who has a wife who is not good looking, ugly. So now for this also, people will object, but then, I mean, generally in Vyakaran also there is a samasa. There is a samasa which is described to explain Bahuri, as I think, Darshana Bharya, something of that sort. I don't remember exactly, but Darshana Bharya is a wife, but how does it become Bharya, Pullinga? To explain Bahuri, it is taken. So one who has a good looking wife, so that person is called as Darshana Bharya. So similarly here, Kurupi means is not good looking, and Durubhashini, who has, you know, whenever she opens her mouth there will be flames. So that kind of picturization is done here. Yasya prapta tasya hridayam sada dukkha krantam eva aste. He'll always face dukkha. Nirvinda hrudaya sa evam manyate. And then one whose, you know, heart is completely depressed. You know, he is depressed. That kind of a depressed person, what does he think? He thinks that Sri Rupam Idam Pindam Mutra Purishadyaneka Shuchipadartha Paripurnam Bhandam. So it is just, you know, a body which is filthy. There is nothing good to look at. Hey Bhagavan, kasya va mama papasya shikshanaya iyam bhavata me datta. So why has Bhagavan given me this kind of a wife? What kind of papa have I done for which I have got this siksha? So mahishasya mahisham iva mahisasya mahishyam iva pishachasya pishachyam iva ushtrasya ushtram iva gardavasya gardabhyam iva manushasyapi tiryagadehi iva. sarva ashuchi nidhanayam striyam moho jayate. So this moha, which is kama purushartha, is, and especially across the genders, it is common in animals also. So there is nothing human about it. Purushartha is moksha. Purushartha nischaya will lead to moksha through dharma, because this is vishesha in manushya. Artha and kama is common across all jivas, not only human beings, but across, you know, animals. All animals are listed, whether it's camel, donkey, or, you know, a buffalo, or a pishacha even, they have attraction to the other gender. So that moha is common. Vairagya mantara, without vairagya, vyabhicharadi dosha rahitayaha striyaha parityage mahan doshaha asya mama striyaha kutsitam vidam rupam durbhashanam cha mama purva karmanusarena praptam. So I have attained this due to old karma, which is fructifying now. This, therefore, I have got this kind of a spouse. Ityevam aharnisham klesham anuhati kurupini patihi. So one who has this kind of a kurupini wife always undergoes this kind of dukkha. Continuously has klesha. Now, what if he has a beautiful wife? Then there will be no vairagya. So, what are the flaws of having a good-looking wife? The flip side, the opposite of that is mentioned here. Yadi punar bharya rupavati madhura bhashini cha. If she is good-looking, beautiful, as well as, you know, does not have a bitter tongue, has a sweet tongue, then daiva vashad bhavati tada. So, one thing that, okay, lot of punya is fructifying. You know, people say, you know, made in heaven couple. Yes, but then tada sa kurupinim apeksha api adhika dukkha hetur bhavati. So, he, bharchu, who has vairagya, he says, if it, the wife is beautiful, it is worse than having an ugly wife. Why so? Kanchana pratim, kanchana pratibhavat kanta bharyatu premna purusham nirjitya tam kamaika parayanam dharmajyanushthana parangmukhancha krutva parama purushartha abhaginam eva vidhati. So vidhati, this, because of that beauty and being attached to that beauty and madhura bhasha, one will be driven away from dharma. So one will become dharma anushthana parangukha, because there will be prema towards, premaspada will be the beautiful wife. Therefore, worse than the kurupi will have vairagya soon. The one who has a kurupi wife will have a vairagya faster than this. So bharchu is saying that that is even worse. So, parama purushartha abhaginam eva vidhati. So, from the perspective of moksha, it's better to not have a beautiful wife. This is how his vairagya thinking is. Further, stri sthangat dhananashaha. So, there is dhananasha also. So, other aspects he is looking at, not only the sharira aspects, but then he says, other ways also there is a loss. Sriyam kama paradhina purusha tasya visha samsrushtam madhuvad apata madhuram alapam shrutva vyamugdha chittah kamandha swapne api tam eva smaran nirjamo na na dhanadyarjanaya yatate. So even, you know, not only he has a fall from dharma, because all the time he is thinking of his wife, then how will he, you know, make dhana also? In laukika vyavahara also, all the time he is thinking of his wife. Grihe va bahirva yat dhanabharana vastradikam labhyate tat sarvam sveshta devataye bharyayehi samarpayati bhakti purvakam. So whatever you know, maybe it's salary or, you know, anything that someone gives him, he offers it to his wife. Meaning, that wife, bharya, herself becomes a swa ishta devata. There is no ishta devata anymore. she is the ishta devata because entire life is centered around the wife. Further what? Sanmarga pradarshakam pradarshaka. So sanmarga pradarshaka mata pitru guruadin na manasa api smarati. So dharma falls from laukika vyavahara and also from sanmarga, which is as taught to take care of mother and father. So parents are also kept away because he does not have enough bandwidth to think about parents. Manasa api na smarati sri rupa karshakaha purusha rupam lulayam mohamayya nasarajva sadradam badhva akrishetaha tatash chalayati. So a comparison is given, just like, you know, a buffalo or a bull has a nasarajju. So they put a thin rope through the nose of the buffalo and then pull it back to keep the buffalo, the bull, in control. So the one who controls that is a karshaka, who is compared with stri here. So the wife controls him as though, you know, he is a bull. Just by pulling onto the rope, the bull can be controlled. So she has the control over the husband. This is the idea given there. Stri sangat dharma nashaha. Dharma also goes away. Panjara baddha shukaha yatha vina vivekam shubhashubhani vachanani anuvadati tatha eva kami purusha dharma 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 dharmau ajanan kantopadesham anu mata pitradin gurun adikshipati. So what was said earlier, that is elaborated here. So not only are the parents not given enough dhana, but dharma of taking care of parents also, we see, I mean, in modern society, we know nuclear families, we know all this. There is nothing new here. Of course, the words may be a little harsh, they come off as harsh, but how else will a person get vairagya? You think about it, it's a fact mentioned in very raw words. Otherwise, you know, it's vairagya, you cannot say that, oh, beautiful person, what a lovely relative, friend, all this you cannot think about. Otherwise, there is no vairagya possible. It should be viveka-driven vairagya. So in viveka, when you inquire into it, what is the body made up of? If you think about it, it is not about the other's body, but then if there is an attraction towards another, then you think about what is it made up of. This is vairagya karaka. And then you come to your own body. Nobody has to explain. You wake up without brushing. You don't even want to, you know, even have your swanubhava. You don't want to deal with this, your own body, without brushing your teeth, without having a bath. Once you wake up, you know what the body is made up of. You don't need to be taught. A person who needs to be taught vairagya about one's own body. So Bhagavan Sridhar Swamiji says that, what vairagya can you teach a person who does not get vairagya by the stink of one's own body, to the sweat? So this is how vairagya is to be brought about. If no other means work, then one has to look at all the possible negatives. So this parrot who is in the cage, like a parrot in the cage, who has no viveka. He hears parrots talk. So the parrots you talk to repeat whatever is heard, they don't understand the words. So whatever is heard, they just repeat. Similarly, this Kami Purusha also, dharma adharma ajanan. He has no bandwidth to look at dharma adharma, to think even. Even if he knows, he has forgotten. Therefore, what happens? He follows whatever the wife says. And thereby, mata pitra adin gurun. So he does not look at whether it is appropriate behavior in front of parents and guru, and even insults them. That is the idea here. Yathacha barhi barhinya purataha bahuda kekalapa purvakam tandam kurvan tam toshayati. So here an example is given is, you know, just dancing around to the dancing to the tune. So similarly is the case of this this person who is completely under the control of the spouse. तथा एव कामातुरः कामिनी वचनं अलंघयन्. सो व्हाई डू यू डू इट? बिकॉज़ माय स्पाउस सेज इट. नो नो शी वोंट लाइक इट. सो देयरफॉर सो बेसिकली कंप्लीटली फॉलोइंग द रूल्स भक्तिपूर्वक नाना वेशधारणेन नटन ताम आह्लादयति. सो डांसिंग टू हर ट्यून, दिस इज यू नो his case. Kami vivekad hiyate, therefore viveka is lacking, and then dharmad brashto bhavati cha. Madhyapo yatha madhya durgandham avigunayan, just like a drunkard, you know, somebody who is a drunkard, he does not care for the stink of the liquor. Others say, oh, this fellow has drunk, you know, he can't stand the stink. But then he has no issues with the, he does not even know that the liquor stinks. Thereby bhrantaha vichyam nashta sanyo bhramati tatha kamandhau stri pumamsau. Now he is landing on both. So he says that this is true with both. Whether it is a man or a woman, being kamandha vivasanau, that itself becomes a vyasana, and then vivasanau atyanta amangalam ashuchi malinancha deham anyonyam gadamalinge nirlajjau lutatah. So you get the meaning. I don't want to talk about this. Kama madaha sanskrutam mati nam api. So kama madaha, one who is intoxicated by kama, sanskrutam mati nam api. Or rather, not one who is, this is not Bahuri, this is Tatpurusha. So, Kama Madaha. The Mada itself, the Mada, the intoxication. So, this is Bhavya Vipatti, Kama Madaha. That works as an intoxication. And then, Sanskrutamati Namapi, this is Bahuri. Those who have Sanskrutamati, a very refined, cultured buddhi, even those kind of panditas have issues, he says, vivekinamapi buddhim kshanena malinayati. It taints the buddhi because the mind is completely taken over. There is no possibility for buddhi to step in and do viveka. Even if they are trained in viveka, they cannot. Ataha. So therefore everything is an afterthought. It is not, oh, I wasted my entire life. Whatever it is. Ataha. Ataeva, Adita Shastra api, those who are panditas, who have studied Shastras, even they have issue with Kama Paravasha, Sri Purushaha. So both the genders have trouble with Kama. Swakiya Parakiyatva Gamya Agamyatvadi Vyavastham Antara Dharma Adharma Viveka Vikalaha Parasparam Ramante. So they indulge in each other without regard for dharma and adharma. Evam kama paravashata purusham va striyam va dharma dharma vivekat prachavya. So prachavya, falling from that, having fallen from dharma and adharma, whether it is purusha or stri, kama paravashata. So the kama paravashata, being under the influence of kama, what happens is this influence itself makes the, so this is a karta, kama paravashata is the karta, kartri, makes the purusha or stri to fall from dharma, adharma, viveka. And having made the people to fall from dharma, adharma, viveka, aneka anartha pradani ashubhani karmani karyati, and makes them do. So causative here, karayati, that kama paravashata, being under the influence of kama itself, makes one do all the karmas which are ashubha. Evam stri vyakti hi kama abhivardhanena, sorry, एवं स्त्री व्यक्ति ही काम अभिवर्धनेन पुरुष बुद्धि मोहन द्वारा नाना विध दुष्कृत आचरण द्वारा च नाना दुख निदानम इति विचार्य. सो इफ वन डज विचार देन वन हैज वैराग्य. देयरफॉर विवेकिनः मुनय स्त्रियादि विषयेभ्यो विरक्ता एकांते रमन्ते. देयर बाय पीपल बिकम वैरागी एंड एकांते रमन्ते. स्त्री संगात बुद्धिनाशः. सो बुद्धिनाश इज ऑल्सो मेन्शन्ड हियर. Because Viveka is not possible, Buddhinasha. Pranivihif pratidinam bhujyamana anna panadi rasa parinamu binduhu. So the last produce of the fruit, which is partaken, the subtlest of the parts, become manaha ityadi. And so in the Chandogya Upanishad Shashto Adhyaya also, there is a mention of which part of food becomes what. But then the final produce is the seed, whether it is for a man or a woman, which contains the entire akara of the human being. And therefore, the entire final produce is a seed, which makes the others to take janma possible, other body, human body possible. Which makes progeny possible. So that bindu is the final produce. And then that is mentioned here. I'll just quickly go through this. I'll not go into details here. Sa eva retaha iti charamadhatu iti chauchyati. It's a charamadhatu, final dhatu, final produce of the sharira. Sarva praninam sa eva jivana adharaha. And since it has the capacity to produce progeny, another human being, if it is retained, then it is said to be jivanadharaha. That itself is jivanadhara. Viveki purusha vrutha bindukshayam akuruvan mahate shreyase kalpate. So one who is committed to moksha, mahat shreyas, will not focus towards progeny, getting a progeny, that is, will save the bindu. Viveki purusha vrutha bindukshayam akuruvan mahate shreyase kalpate samyak samrakshito bindu praninam ojas tejo viryam balancha adatte. So this is what is called in Gita Shastra and other in Upanishad. We see the urdhva retaha purusha. So purusha is mentioned, sannyas is mentioned, urdhva retas pratipadika. So reta does not go out because of not being parangmukha. Is pratyang mukha, becoming inward, there is no outward focus at all. Therefore, the retaha gets converted into ojas, into energy. It is absorbed energy and therefore it starts moving upwards, not downwards, but the energy moves upwards. So this is how the Yoga Shastras mention it. Therefore, virya, bala, teja, all this is due to preserving health finally. Yena bindu saurakshitaha, tasya deha roga jaradyanabhibhutaha, pushtya kantyache virajate, tasya indriyani patutarani vashikrutani cha bhavanti. And thereby, there is a dependency both ways. They grow upon each other. The more the vairagya, the more the urdhva retastvam, and then more the urdhva retastvam, the more is the indriya control. Manascha shoka moha janibhibhutam sada prasannam ekagram antarmukhancha bhavati deepaha taileneva purusho binduna ojasvi tejasi balishtascha virajate. This is explanation of the earlier. Yo jitendriya swapne api askhalita binduhu saha balarogya adi man prasanna indriya manaha shubha karmani acharan kramena labdhatma tattva jnana samsara bhayad vimuchyate. This kind of a person, vairagi, therefore vairagyam is the second qualification. Viveka being there, it will definitely lead to vairagya. Then only shamadamadi shatka sampatti is possible. Thereby a person can become real mumukshu. And then only jnanotpatti is possible, nishtha is possible. This is how the Shastras explain. So this is a sum up of that. thereby samsara bhayat vimuchyate yogina siddhascha bindu samrakshana balenaiva khechari mudra abhyasadina animadi siddhi siddhim urdhvaretastam shreshtyam shreshtyancha abhajanta. Sorry, I'm making many mistakes. I just want to go through this quickly. I don't want to spend more time here. And these words are all, you know, not very common in Vedanta Shastra. So, yogina siddhascha bindu saurakshana balenaiva khechari mudra abhyasadina. So, there is a khechari mudra described in Yoga Shastra. Khechari mudra helps the conversion of reta to ojas. So anyway, this is there in Hatha Yoga as well as in Kundalini Shakti Path. Very dangerous to do it by oneself. So for this, there is a Diksha needed, Khechari Diksha. And this leads to Siddhis also. Those who are involved, I mean, committed to Siddhis, they are, you know, they don't get Shraishtyam. But then those who let the Siddhis be, don't focus there, they become Urdhvareta and they get Shraishtyam. It leads to Moksha because Kundalini reaching Sahasra gives that kind of Viveka that a simple Mahavakya Shravana can lead to Mukti. But then, in fact, in Sampradaya, in Orthodoxy, this Khechari is recommended as a sadhana to all sadhakas. It is recommended even to sannyas, especially to sannyasis, Khechari mudra is recommended. Anyway, so I'll go through this. It's quite a long section. I thought that I'll finish it off today, but then there are some points which I wanted to comment on. Anyway, I'll try to complete this tomorrow and we'll move on to better sections of why this Bharchu Katha. We'll see that in the next part. Sukar Nityam Saprakasham Vyapakan Namurva Adhishthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddhir Drukyati Nirun Aparam Sra Vedanta Vedyam Pratyak Paramah Tadeva Annamattva Nityati Menishchitamatihi. Namaste.
Hari Om.